training on you and taking things out of you. Then that's why, yeah, conversation earlier, yeah. And this was on the train this time, not a bus, so it's slightly different. I think I'm doing this journey thing. The leeches grow fat as my life forces drain. I can no longer take the strain of the thousand moths eaten at the clock of my refrain. The cold steel of their blaze brings both pleasure and pain, but I must refrain. The leech of their lies eating through my brain, my whole being is shouting out in pain. Bleeding alive lies making me insane, but I must continue to refrain from the game. And through the pain I hear a quiet refrain. You walk in light where there is none. You must not fight if the game is to be won. You must shine to set yourself free. And all I want to do is get all that these leeches and moths off me. When it was just moths, I thought I was free. But where there was once a few, there are now too many to see. They crept in slowly before I could see the drain they were having on me. But I can handle them as I remember who I am and who I ought to be. But the leeches with the lies and many disguises are too much for me, masquerading as friends, but to whose bitter end are putting an extra strain on me. But I continue to hear the quiet refrain, you walk in light where there is none. You must not fight if the game is to be won. You must shine to be set yourself free. The refrain gets louder as I near the end of the day, and I hear my voice shouting as my life force is sucked away. Not today.
Okay.
And how interesting that we had the conversation earlier about, you know, people, family, friends,
yeah,
and the energy they even take from you or drain from you. And I think in essence all we can be is the us.
I think it's also the energy that we give to others. I have a metaphor in my head about gardens. And I think sometimes you spend so much time helping people and like tending their gardens, their lives, yeah? And then one day you go to sit back in your own and relax,
mm-hmm,
and you realise that it's full of weeds, there's not a place spare for you to sit on or lie down on. And then you look around and there's no one to help you sort out your garden. And then it's at that point you think, oh, what's going on? And you call people and they've got no time for you, so it's not a healthy place to be.
Yeah. It's like people, there are people that they tire themselves out doing stuff for others, but they don't realise that they'll burn themselves out, and what good will that do for the people they need to care for if they don't look after themselves?
Mm.
Hard lesson to learn, I think. It's taken me a long time to learn that. The last one I'm going to read is a bit more like hard things.